So as you can see here, I've got my crankshaft component loaded up in here. What I want to do is I want to do a shape generator. I want to generate a mesh for this to see where, you know, maybe I could lighten this up because I'm concerned about the overall weight of this in my assembly. So you can see here from the 3D model tab, there's the shape generator option. So I'm going to select that. And you can see that it's just giving me a little notification here of what this does. And it's really just a link to the help. Now, if once you get comfortable with it, you probably don't want to see this again. Notice that there is the do not show me again option to turn that off. So just kind of a welcome to shape generator type message here. So I've clicked OK, and what it's done is it's created the new study. Notice that we can create multiple studies. So maybe I want to see, you know, 15% reduction in the mass. Maybe I want to say 25%. Maybe I want to do one where it's made out of steel. Maybe another one maybe where it's made out of aluminum. I mean, I can do various type studies like that. So where I am going to start, I'm going to start and make sure that the material is assigned correctly. So you can see that steel high strength here was assigned to the part. So I'm actually okay with that. I can come in here and actually override it and actually change it from whatever the part component happened to be in that case. But like I said, I'm actually okay with that. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to spin this around just a little bit. And I'm going to apply a fixed constraint to the bottom here. So I'm going to fix it in that area there and I'm going to click OK. Next, what I want to do is I'm going to apply the force here. So I'm going to select force, and I'm just going to pick this top face here. And I'm going to assign 1,000 newtons here, but it's not really that what I want. What I want to do is I actually want to angle this a bit. So I know that this one actually needs to be negative 700, and I want it in the X direction. I want that to be 300 newtons. So I'm just going to angle that just a little bit so we can see what's going to happen, because I'm assuming that the force is going to come down at an angle. It's not going to come straight down at the top there. So I'm going to click OK, and you can see that we can apply pressures and bearing loads and moments. I did it as a fixed constraint, but notice that there's pin constraints. You know, if I pause here, it kind of gives me a quick explanation of what that is. I can also do frictionless constraints if I just want to keep it on a particular face. Now this groove here is actually really important. So the groove here is important because that's where an O-ring is going to go, let's say. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to preserve that region. So I'm going to select that region. I can see that the region's been made as a cylinder automatically. I can see the orientation of it. And I could actually, you know, bump this up a bit if, you know, just because the radius is currently 4.76, maybe I want to bump that up a little bit. Now if I expand this, we can see that I can also override the center point. But in this case, I'm going to click OK. And what it's done is gone through there and highlighted that. So that's the region that I want to be able to maintain. So I don't want that to change at all. Okay, so now that I've got the material assigned, I've got my constraints, I've got my loads. Notice that there's also two other options I forgot about. I've preserved the regions, which is optional. You don't have to do that. And I'm going to go my shape generator options here. And what I want to do is I just want to do a 20% reduction. So right now I can see that it's, you know, 0.524 kilograms. I'm looking for a 20% reduction so I can see what the target mass is going to be. I'm just going to make the mesh resolution here a little bit finer. Notice I do get a warning here that, you know, expect a slightly longer time. So I'm going to click OK. So again, I've gone through kind of left to right. It's kind of my favorite way of setting that. And I'm going to come in here and I'm going to generate the shape. So at this point, it's showing me here one study, one configuration. I'm going to click run and it's going to go through and run that. Now this is a pretty simple part. There's not a lot going on in there, so it shouldn't take that long. There are obviously, you know, as your geometry becomes more complex, this might be a get up and go for coffee type moment. But it is doing its thing. It can do its thing unintended. And once it's done, we'll see the mesh that it creates. All right, so you can see up here in the corner that we did reach our 15% reduction. We can see the new mass. And as I take this and kind of spin this around here, I can actually get an idea. Whoops. I can actually get an idea of what's going on here. So I can see right now that, you know, based on the direction of the force and how it's fixed, I can see the areas where it's suggesting that I can remove material. Now, if I wanted to, I could go back and adjust it and say, well, let's see what happens if we bump up the force and we ask for a 25% reduction and have it regenerate the mesh. Now, at this point, I could click Finish Analysis because I kind of got an idea, but what I want to do is kind of bring this back into the model. So I'm going to select the Promote Shape option here, and I could export this out actually to an STL file. So if it's something I wanted to go get printed right away, 3D printed, I could do that. In this case, though, what I want to do is I want to overlay it over top of my existing model so it gives me an idea of what needs to be removed. So you can see here that the shape was added to the part browser, and it gives me some recommended steps here. So it says change visual style of the part to wireframe and use the shape as a guideline. All right, so we can see that in the browser here, it's giving me a report, so I'm gonna see where this extra model came from. And notice that it has added this crankshaft component in here, which is a mesh feature. So if I right click on it, I can turn it off. I can actually show the mesh edges if that helps me kind of see what's going on. I can suppress it if I don't want to see it currently at the moment. And I'm going to go to the View tab here, like it said, and I'm going to go down here and I'm going to select Wireframe. And what it does then is it turns off the model so I can see just the mesh component. So the mesh component kind of always stays translucent, as you can see here. So the idea would be is you would turn it off when you didn't want to see it anymore. So if I was to come in here and I was to flip, let's say, to a wireframe with hidden edges, then we get a little bit more detail of what's going on. Now, why would I want to do this again is I could now use this to chop away at the model. So maybe what I would want to do is you know, create a sketch from this side here because I can kind of see some area. So it looks like I can create some slots in here to remove some material. Here again, you know, maybe I wouldn't go quite that extreme, but it gives me an idea of where there's, you know, less stresses and where I can remove material without impacting the overall strength and integrity of this component.